Are you an entrepreneur or looking to become one? Looking to stay motivated, find happiness and true success? You're in the right place. Welcome to Empower Humans.
Welcome to episode 32 of the Empower Humans podcast. I'm traveling this week, so I hope you don't hear too much extra background noise or things like that, but there will be some. I apologize. And the message is going to be so powerful, though, that it'll all be drowned out. You're going to forget I even said that. I'm excited for this episode because we're talking about a formula for building momentum in our lives. Tension plus passion equals momentum. We have some great material, including some stories and parables, to kind of get this message across in all kinds of different ways. The concept is that tension is produced by all the trials and friction that take place, along with our own burning desires, which is, in the physical sense, kind of the same type of thing of what needs to go on within us to actually build some momentum in our lives. This friction and tension is what generates energy. That, combined with passion, the pressure within becomes greater than the pressure outside, and that is where momentum is built, my friends. And before we dig deeper into that topic, I want to remind you, as always, that you are priceless. There's nobody quite like you. You have been given talents and traits that are unique to you, and you were born with this priceless inherent worth. I've used that phrase before. That cannot be changed, no matter what people say, what people do. Les Brown says we were born dumb, naked, and helpless, essentially. All the rest of the stuff are things that we learned or things that we told ourselves. So don't let anyone tell or convince you otherwise. You are definitely priceless and irreplaceable. And in addition to those facts, I remind you also that you are never alone. Don't tell yourself you're alone. Again, we're talking about what we tell ourselves. Our life becomes a byproduct of the story we tell ourselves about ourselves. And we're going to talk more about that in this episode a little bit too, as to some things that happen. In fact, I just mentioned Les Brown. I've been listening to a lot of his material. We're going to talk more about some of that as it relates to this particular topic. But when it comes down to this situation, the reality is that I am one of almost countless people and organizations in the world there to support and love you. So don't feel alone. I know various types of situations and people might be listening to this podcast. So if you're in any of those kind of categories right now in your life, please know you're priceless and you're never alone. Contact us, send me messages directly through empowerhumans.com, at empower101 on Instagram and Twitter. I'm here for you to share and remind you of those things that we're talking about. And with today's topic, tension plus passion equals momentum. That's why I said it earlier, momentum. But I want to focus on that topic and not take it lightly, because these are facts. Like I said at the top of the podcast here, the pressure within must be greater than the pressure outside. And with that, we can really build momentum. That's basically what happens when there's an explosion. Also, we can be our own explosions in a good way. We don't need to cause any damage or hurt anybody, but we can really gain momentum and do amazing things. Why do you think we created this math equation of tension plus passion equals momentum? We're going to get into some of the roots of those words in a moment after I tell you a little story, kind of a symbolic parable. And you know me, I love digging in with words because it gives us some real insight as to what things really kind of mean at deeper levels. And before we jump into that story or parable, I want you to think as clearly as possible of what you want in life. What is lacking that needs to be filled or changed? Have you thought of what you want out of life? Have you done that? I don't know your situation, your age, whatever your current station and circumstances of life, but have you thought of that from this point moving forward or in the past? If you've got something lined up that you've already figured out, great, let's build on that. Have you gotten to know yourself? Or have an idea of the things you can contribute to this world? This world and all our relationships are not about getting, they're about giving. And we'll talk more about giving in the not too distant future as well, and maybe another episode, but keep that in mind. It's not about getting, it's about giving. Think of what you want and can contribute. Have you ever ridden a train? This is the parable we're going to talk about here. I've ridden a few myself, including the one at Disneyland and a few other kind of short journeys. I haven't ridden cross country in a train. It sounds like an amazing thing to do, and I've heard of some beautiful places you can ride trains up the California and Oregon coastline, and even in Asia and other places throughout the world. Trains take a lot of energy to build momentum. Freight trains in particular start very slowly and gradually exert force, tension, energy to get that thing moving. What else does a train require? A track. Okay, the train couldn't start or have any direction without a track. The friction would just be too great without it. A track is kind of like having a clear vision of where you're going and what it takes to get there. My boys and I love watching the Polar Express at Christmas time. Don't know if you've seen that movie. It's an animated movie. Tom Hanks does some of the voices and stuff in the movie. The train in that particular movie has a set destination like most trains. It's going to the North Pole, goes through all sorts of crazy sections of track to get there. When we think of what it took to build these rail lines, the real ones, not the ones in the Polar Express, which is a great movie, by the way, but the rail lines, the real ones that exist in our world these days, these tracks for the trains, they had to know what direction to head and what obstacles would be faced on that path to kind of smooth that path and allow the train to get where it needs to go. We have to get coal to start moving the engine and generate the energy to get that train in motion as well. You watch the wheels go as you take the first steps, putting that proverbial coal in your engine and the fire that is created that generates the energy and gets those wheels turning. You watch the wheels go slowly at first. And I think about that as we think about any moving object. Objects in motion stay in motion with the same speed and the same direction unless acted upon by an unbalanced outside force. This is why we have to build momentum within ourselves. Just like a train gets going, may appear slow or weak at first, before you know it, the momentum propels it along so it glides on these tracks. This clarity of purpose and direction for our purposes here is what we're talking about with a train track. It moves forward with such momentum that'd be difficult to stop eventually. It just takes a little bit of time to kind of build up that speed, and then it gets to full speed, just like you're flying an airplane, gets to full speed in the air, and you almost don't feel like you're moving through the air. You're just on a plane at a constant speed. In fact, when we get back to trains talking about this, heavy trains need to begin stopping usually at least a mile before they can come to a complete stop. That's the kind of momentum and weight we're talking about. That's a powerful momentum to think about. A mile. It takes a mile to stop some of these freight trains, and they can be over 100 cars long. But again, this is a parable, this is a story. The same would be true of exerting incredible force to dislodge a boulder and start it rolling down a hill. Well, once it begins rolling, it would gain speed. It would start slowly at first, but gradually and quickly, it would actually become unstoppable just about. Even rockets that we've propelled into outer space use more energy to get off the ground and out of the Earth's atmosphere than the entire rest of their journey. And in some cases, maybe going to the moon and back, it's still the same. More energy is exerted getting it off the ground and out of the Earth's atmosphere. So all these kind of moving objects, boulders and cars and trains and airplanes, all these different things, it's kind of like we're creating a movie, planes, trains, and automobiles here. All these things have some laws surrounding them that apply to this building momentum, because that's what momentum refers to. It's a speed. It's a force moving forward towards something. So why all this talk of moving vehicles? Again, I think there are symbols and parables all around us to teach us how to gain our best life. In this world, you have to be willing to take those first slow steps that require patience and endurance and some greater exertion to start any meaningful momentum forward. That's just the reality of it. We have to be willing to start with those first things to get something moving and exert a lot of force to get it going, whether you want to build a great business or lose weight or rebuild your marriage or whatever the situation might be. It takes some force to turn something around, just because in some cases something was already in motion that got us to this place. And in the case maybe of losing weight, that we have to change course and turn that thing around sometimes. And again, these are just facts. The reason the equation is so important is because it starts to add fuel and purpose to that process. Tension plus passion equals momentum. There we go again, saying it like that. But again, it's no joke. Just lighten the mood a little bit. The word tension, actually, you know me again, I love talking about roots of words because it gives us some real deeper meaning. The word tension has Latin roots in the Latin word tendere, which means to stretch. Tension occurs when something is stretched physically or emotionally. Think of a rubber band and how it creates tension, which increases as it is stretched. I sometimes travel, as I am right now, I travel with resistance bands so I can maybe do some exercise while I'm on the road. That creates some tension, causes you to exert force through your muscles. Now, remember our equation, tension plus passion equals momentum. The word passion is an interesting one because the Latin roots in passionum, I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but it basically means suffering or enduring. This is why we hear the phrase passion of the Christ, for example. Early meanings of the word passion refer to that, and it still refers to that to this day in some capacity. If we really think deeply about it, the root of suffering makes sense when connected with the more modern use of the word passion, referring to kind of an ardent affection or a deep desire or interest or devotion. The dictionary even uses the word intense in describing the word passion, intense, which is connected to the word tense or tension. Okay, so it's all kind of combined and tied together in some capacity. Things we desire require tension and some suffering. Suffering, as in the case of my resistance bands or different types of exercise, is the path to growth also. Remember the roots of sacrifice? We talked recently about this. The roots of that word literally mean to make holy. The word holy is directly connected to the word whole. W-H-O-L-E, or complete, okay? We must pay a price for the things we want. We must pay a price for the things we want. Just like you pay to put fuel in your car, or fuel in the form of food in your body and water, we must pay for the opportunity of that energy to propel us forward in some direction. This, my friends, is how we build momentum. It's actually a simple concept. But the biggest factor, in my opinion, is building enough inner tension and desire that the pressure within becomes greater than the pressure outside, as Les Brown told us, so we can be unstoppable, like the freight train at full speed. The pressure within has to be greater than the pressure outside, almost like physics, but in the quantum realm of what we're trying to do and become in our lives. Lay down your tracks of purpose and clarity and become that freight train, my friends. The only thing stopping us is ourselves, in particular the stories we tell ourselves of who we are and what we're about and what sorts of limitations, if any, that we have. Now, like I said, I've been listening to a lot of this powerful material from Les Brown, the acclaimed motivational speaker. When he was born back in the 1940s, along with his twin brother, they were born in an abandoned building in Miami. He was adopted and eventually declared what's called educable mentally retarded while in grade school, which basically meant that he wasn't able to learn as well or as quickly or contribute as much. And a school teacher in high school and his adoptive mother encouraged his full potential and to break that past, that use of these labels, to see his true value and worth. This man broke those bands, almost like rubber bands we talked earlier, broke that tension, created his own new reality. He actually became a member of the Ohio House of Representatives from the late 70s to the early 80s. He's also spoken to millions as a speaker for decades, and he speaks with real power. Okay, that label of educable mentally retarded created kind of a delusional glass ceiling over his head, and realizing that he didn't have to be limited by that label, that creation of friction and tension, he kind of had new, renewed desires for greater things that he built momentum on and became his own freight train, a different direction, that he could actually change that label, that delusion that existed previously in his childhood. I love this guy and his material. Go look him up on lesbrown.com or dozens of videos on YouTube and other audio programs, various sources. He clearly overcame these obstacles from literally the moment he was born in that abandoned building in Miami, and did and became amazing in all kinds of ways, and has inspired and blessed lives galore during his lifetime. In fact, let me share with you a few powerful quotes I took note of from some of this material I've listened to recently. Les Brown said, quote, "Passion is God's will in you," end quote. Passion is God's will in you. Whatever your belief is on spiritual matters and God and so forth, but I love the quote. He also said, quote, "Most people don't fail in life because they aim too high and miss. Most people fail because they aim too low and hit," end quote. Think about that. Aim too low and hit, so people get in like a comfort zone, and then no more progress, no more expansion, no more growth. Oh, I hit this. I finally kind of got to a place where I can be comfortable. And it doesn't mean you don't be comfortable in life, but we always have to have in the back of our minds an idea of growth and contribution. Remember, we've said recently, if you're not growing, you're dying. I learned that from Tony Robbins. Les Brown also gave a speech titled, It's Not Over Until You Win. What a powerful title. We could sit and talk about that, or at least ponder over it for hours and hours at a time. It's not over until you win. He also said that, quote, service is the rent we pay for the space we take up on earth, end quote. He told us to begin with a vision so big that when obstacles arise, they don't obscure our view. Do you see the power of all this, that a man like that could overcome those labels and those early life obstacles and deficiencies? You can do that. Here are some ways I'm going to share with you to build momentum, maintain real momentum towards the things you actually want, and start your day with positive forces. All this starts with focusing, by the way, on the things we want, not the things we don't want. I've said that a lot of times for all of us, including myself. We've got to remind ourselves and focus on the things we want, okay? And as we start our day with positive forces, which is, again, the first thing I'm going to share with you of eight things we're going to go over here, these positive forces can be motivational messages or scriptures, depending on your belief system. They can be positive and uplifting music combined with focusing on what I would say is number two on this list, is setting and acting on our goals. Focus on those goals while you're listening to positive music or other things like that. And that can also be a positive influence and momentum building activity. Lay down the tracks of your freight train with these goals. Have a clear path and a destination. That's what goals are all about, my friends. Sometimes people don't like the word goals. I didn't used to like the word. So call them plans, you know, with a more definitive outcome. Number three, replace bad habits with good habits and expand upon the existing good habits. This is like cleaning out your engine with an oil change. Clean out the dirt and gunk in your life and replace it with new, fresh, and more effective oil to power your engine, so to speak. Habits are kind of like the oil in your engine as you build momentum. Okay, number four, create a balanced set of tasks and execute them. It always helps to kind of know the night before your agenda for the next day. Make sure that agenda includes some time for thought and meditation, but have that agenda be in line with your goals and objectives. And it also helps to have different categories of what Stephen Covey would call your areas of influence in your life, and make your goals and tasks balance all of that accordingly based on these areas of influence that matter in your life. Number five is surround yourself with others seeking similar things. That will only add to your momentum. Remember, we said objects in motion stay in motion unless acted upon by opposing forces. The flip side of that coin is that momentum can build even faster by having others around you contribute to your existing and building momentum. So have other like-minded people around you to help kind of build and push your momentum forward. Number six is to constantly keep learning and growing. You have to continue to develop your knowledge and your skills. Don't get comfortable, because there's always room for additional growth and learning, okay? That's something we need to talk more about here soon, I think, getting comfortable and comfort zones and how that all applies, but also continuing to learn and grow and progress. Number seven might be kind of counterintuitive for some, but meet new people, attend events related to your area of growth and or expertise. This could be in business, this could be related to all kinds of different areas of your life, but attend these events. You can network, you can develop relationships, you can volunteer. All of these things are fulfilling, and they'll also add to your momentum. And the number eight thing is to celebrate your wins. Set milestones along the path of your train tracks, so to speak. These symbolic train tracks we're talking about, moving forward and building our momentum. Set milestones along the way so that you have some markers by which to gauge your progress and to celebrate as you go. When you achieve things, there's incentive through some sort of celebration of these obtaining these milestones. This will help to continue to propel us forward, okay? Celebrate these wins along the way. There are a lot more things we could add to this, but I want you to know that I believe in you, and I know you are great. I know you have a fire within you. I don't necessarily know all of you individually at the moment as we move forward with this podcast, but I know that as human beings, we have a fire in us, and it can be a massive force for good in all the areas of our life that matter. Your family, your business, etc. Just fan those flames and build that momentum and glide on those tracks after we lay them out clearly and individually as to what the track and path is for you. Visit empowerhumans.com for more content and information on these subjects. And I want to remind you also of our challenges, which are constant and which bear repeating with each episode. There's three challenges for anyone just joining us for the first time, and you might hear these if you listen to other episodes. You surely will, actually. But the first of the challenges is study. Keep studying if you've been studying. Start studying if you haven't. Just like we said earlier, we have to constantly be progressing, learning, growing. If we're not growing, we're dying. Keep learning, keep growing, keep progressing, keep finding areas that you can learn something and add and refine your knowledge and skills and mindset. That's what this is all about. There's audiobooks. I mentioned previously this Hoopla digital app, which at least in the US and North America is available through local library systems. You can download audiobooks. A lot of it's free. Actually, I think it's all free because it's through the local library system. So get that Hoopla digital. And by the way, in this day and age, I recently heard an interview from Ed Milette. He was interviewing Rachel Hollis, and they said that in this day and age where there's so much information, ignorance is a choice. Okay, I don't mean to be so blunt about it, but that's the reality in this day and age. Ignorance is a choice. Okay, so let's learn, let's grow, let's study. The second of the challenges is make great moments. Find and make opportunities for people to feel like they matter. Fix things if you did something wrong. Do whatever we need to do to make great moments. With your children, surprise them. Get them a gift that's not for their birthday. And take kids to some activity that maybe they didn't expect. These surprise things are making great moments for us and can also offset some of these other things that we might have as maybe regrets. We talked in the last episode about regrets. So go back and listen to that and all the other episodes if you haven't. Listen to all these things, but make great moments along the way. That's what's going to make your life matter. You're going to have pillars along the way of, oh yeah, I remember that and that and that and that, that will be great moments that you can look back upon and be proud of the life you lived. And the last thing, as always, let's keep doing this podcast together. I love you. I'm grateful for you. I'm flattered that you listen to these episodes. It's what keeps me going. Comment on these episodes through the Podbean app or send messages through empowerhumans.com, at empower101 on Instagram and Twitter, whatever it might be. And we look forward to hearing from you, responding to you, engaging with you. Keep our momentum going. We'll keep your momentum growing. Remember, tension plus passion equals momentum. Let's do this together, my friends. And until next time, empower yourself, empower the world around you.
Thanks so much for listening to Empower Humans. If you enjoyed the show, please rate and review this podcast. For more great content and to stay up to date, visit empowerhumans.com. We'll catch you next time.